In this tutorial, I want to share with you how to add background images to your Excel spreadsheet. Okay, so you can have it to look kind of much more professional when you're delivering a presentation to your panel, to make it a little bit look different from the normal way we used to have our spreadsheet look. Okay, so to add a background image, all you need to do is to start by coming to page layout. Okay, and you can see background over here. You can click on it. And once you click on background, you have a bunch of options in which you can bring in backgrounds. For example, you can import an image from a file that you have within your computer. And the second method is you can browse Bing search engine, and then you can bring in a particular image and you have it inserted as a background within your computer. Okay, or if you have an image saved in your OneDrive, you can easily also browse to your OneDrive and have it inserted in your computer. So let's try to have a file or a picture from a computer, and let's see how it looks and what are the benefits and the downside. Okay, so we navigate to within our computer and take in any image. We take this image and we click on insert, and we can see it has inserted it, but everything kind of looks weird because you cannot even see your data at this point. Okay, so for you to see your data clearly, you have to come over here and select the entire data, and then you can come over to home and you can change the view, the color, from color it is black to white. Okay, only then you can see, and even now it's not so clear. Now, one of the key downsides is when you try to reduce the sizing of the document or of the spread workbook, you can see that the image does not change its size, only the data change in size, but the image remains the way it is, even though it is repeated continuously. All right, it repeated, but the image is not, the data is not affected by the image. The image remain where it is, even if you try to increase the size. So let's try to increase and see what happens. Even with increase, nothing changed as regards the image affecting our data. So the image remains the same. Okay, so this is not a good way to insert a background. Okay, so let's try to undo and let's try another method. Okay, so let's try to insert from a Bing search engine. So we can come to page layout, we can come to backgrounds, and we can search from the Bing search engine, let's say speech, and we can search for it. So remember to put it this Creative Commons license, so these are license free images you can easily use and reuse and share with your friends easily, right? So let's say we are taking one of those, and if you want to have more images, you can uncheck this Creative Commons only, and you can have a bunch of images, but these are not free images, so be careful what you use in your document. So for example, let's say we go with Creative Commons only, and we can check around to find anyone. For example, we can go with this one and we can say insert, and this is going to insert it in the background. Yeah, and I think it kind of looks cool, but I think the effect is almost the same like the other one as well. All right, so if you try to increase or decrease, the same thing happens. You can see the same thing happens. When you try to decrease also, the same thing happens. So let's undo and try to add an image from, and try to show the best way to add an image into our Microsoft Excel. So the one of the best ways is to come to insert and come to illustrations over here, and you can come to pictures. All right, you just click on pictures and you can come all the way to pictures from device or stock images. So at this point you can insert from device, and easily you can bring in a picture, any picture of your choice, for example this one, and we can insert it. Okay, so right now it is sitting in front of the document, is in front of our data, so you get free to move it around, and you're free to even resize it from the edges over here. You can resize and you can move it around to different kind of location, to different location. But the best part is if you want to have it to move or to show in the best way possible, is to double click on this image, and you can see this picture format coming up. Okay, so you have the bunch of, you have the opportunity to change it to a bunch of other options. You can put in different kind of features. You can even put this their 3D view, and you have to have this kind of reflected level effect, and you can make it to be a circle, and you can appear in a very different way. You can give it some cinematic look. okay, and it kind of look kind of much more professional and nice. But then you can have other additionally you can have other features like transparency. For example, you can make it transparent and you can change the level of transparency, and you can see as you are navigating, as you hover over the document, you can see the transparency is kind of working, but then you have the transparency increasing or decreasing, and you can see the background is there. It has even taken the document behind the data, and you can see that you can easily increase the size accordingly. You can increase the size to have it cover the whole thing, and you can see now it kind of makes it looks fantastic and interesting, and you can see your data clearly. So you can see like this organizational chart, you can see it clearly, but then you have the image as your background. And even when you want to try to print it, you can see the preview, print preview, and you see a preview of it. It's going to take in that background as part of it, unlike before when you have a background. When you have a normal background, for example, we can delete this. And when we have a normal background, if you have the image in the background, you may not be able to print it. So let's have a look at an example of that. For example, when you have it in the background and you attempt to print, you will not be able to see it in the preview. Okay, it's not there in the preview, and you can see it's not there. Okay, so but when you put the image in the same way that we've just explained, something like this, you will be able to see it, and I think it kind of looks kind of good and perfect without affecting much of the data, because they are quite visible to the audience. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, these are just few ways in which you can add images to your content. You can bring in images to your Excel spreadsheet. Feel free to try it on your own. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.